NCAA March Madness 2005.
Hi, I'm Bill Self, head basketball coach of the University of Kansas Jayhawks, and I'm here to tell you about something that will revolutionize basketball video games. It's called the Floor General Play Calling System, and you can only find it in NCAA March Madness 2005. Take it from me, every great team has a great point guard. You can be your team's great point guard with the Floor General Play Calling System. NCAA March Madness 2005 will revolutionize the way basketball games are played with a new floor general play calling system for offensive and defensive sets. Here's how it works. You've got three plays to choose from. All of these plays are fully customizable in the front end. Choose one play. My Jayhawks will be running a 1-4 high. Bring up your pass and dribble options and wait for everyone to get into position. There are a number of options for each play. First option that we're going to show you out of a 1-4 high set is a pass to the wing. After the point guard passes the ball to the wing, the big guy in the high post will set a back screen for him as he looks to come off it to the strong side corner. In this situation, the point guard is open in the corner for a good 3-point shot. The second option is a dribble entry, where the point guard takes the dribble to the wing and in turn pushes the wing player to come off a staggered screen on the weak side. This is especially effective when the player coming off the staggered screen is a good three-point shooter. Here's a coach's tip. To increase the likelihood of your pass getting to the open man, bring your ball handler back towards the middle of the floor before you make the pass. Each school has a different playbook with a number of plays to choose from. Get familiar with your playbook, and you can dominate your opponent when you run your best stuff against them. Floor general play calling works the same way on defense. Here, my Jayhawks are playing good, solid half-court man-to-man defense. Using floor general play calling, we're able to quickly change our defense and switch to a 2-3 zone to confuse the offense and get the stop. When things aren't going your way, be sure to put your coaching hat on and call a timeout. In the new timeout menu, you've got the option to make a substitution or call a play, and you've only got 30 seconds to do so. Don't forget to check out the 25 toughest places to play. These venues have the biggest home court advantages in America, as the fans are the craziest and most loyal you'll ever come across. Feel that home court advantage as the away team when the camera shakes a tip-off and during free throws. Every successful college basketball team has a great point guard who takes command of the offense and is an extension of the coach on the floor and leads his team to victory. This player is known as the floor general, and I can tell you firsthand that this player is invaluable to the team's success. And your ability to master floor general play calling will be crucial while playing NCAA March Madness 2005. Go KU!
NCAA March Madness 2005. NCAA March Madness 2005. NCAA March Madness 2005.
NCAA March Madness 2005.
NCAA March Madness 2005. NCAA March Madness 2005. NCAA March Madness 2005.
It's in the game!
It's in the game!
NCAA March Madness 2005. NCAA March Madness 2005.
NCAA March Madness 2005. EA Sports is in the game.
NCAA March Madness 2005. NCAA March Madness 2005.
It is a game! Whoa!
NCAA March Madness 2005. NCAA March Madness 2005.
Stars! EA Sports is in the game!
NCAA March Madness 2005. NCAA March Madness 2005.
C-A-R-D-S, EA Sports is in the game!
Yeah! NCAA March Madness 2005.
EA Sports is in the gizzle.
NCAA March Madness 2005. NCAA March Madness 2005.
EA Sports! EA Sports!
If it's in the game,
it's in the game! Go you! You! Go you!
NCAA March Madness 2005. NCAA March Madness 2005. NCAA March Madness 2005. NCAA March Madness 2005.
EA Sports, go Heels! It's in the game! EA Sports! It's in the game!
NCAA March Madness 2005.
EA Sports!
EA Sports, it's in the game!
NCAA March Madness 2005.
EA Sports! It's in the game!
EA Sports!
It's in the game.
It's in the game!
Oh! NCAA March Madness 2005. NCAA March Madness 2005.
EA Sports!
It's in the game! Go Polar!
NCAA March Madness 2005.
Yeah!
NCAA March Madness 2005.
You gotta boiler up, baby!
EA Sports!
EA Sports!
It's in the game!
It's in the game!
Yeah! NCAA March Madness 2005. NCAA March Madness 2005.
Hi, I'm Tubby Smith, head coach Kentucky Wildcats, and I'm in the game.
NCAA March Madness 2005.
EA Sports March Madness 2005!
These cats are wild.
C-A-T-S-S-S-S!
NCAA March Madness 2005.
EA Sports!
We're the Wildcats! We're in the game!
NCAA March Madness 2005.
Everyone's a Lobo! Woo, woo, woo! It's in the game! Go, go,
go! NCAA March Madness 2005.
Hi, I'm Richie McKay, University of New Mexico basketball, and I'm in the game.
NCAA March Madness 2005.
EA Sports!
It's in the game!
It's in the game!
Go Lobo!
NCAA March Madness 2005.
Let's go, man!
NCAA March Madness 2005.
EA Sports! We're the Badgers! We're in the game!
NCAA March Madness 2005. NCAA March Madness 2005.
If it's in the game, it's in the game.
EA Sports, it's in the game.
EA Sports, it's in the game. Let's go Red, let's go Red.
NCAA March Madness 2005.
On March 26, 1979, the Hick from French Lick led Indiana State to a title game against a magical player and his Michigan State team. The game became an instant classic, which Michigan State won 75-64. The two stars took their games onto the pro ranks, where their personal rivalry changed the basketball landscape forever. Not expected to be a major factor for UNC, a little-known freshman hit a shot that would mark the beginning of an era at North Carolina and would change the basketball world forever. firmly establishing himself as a go-to player up to that point in the tournament. Number 23 hit many clutch shots, but none bigger than the one he hit with 13 seconds left on the clock to send Georgetown and their legendary big man down in defeat 63-62 to claim what would be the first of a career full of great moments. The University of Virginia, with their superstar center leading the way, were the number one ranked team in college basketball and were expected to walk right through the competition at the EA Sports Maui Invitational. Division II Chaminade had other ideas. After replicating the Virginia center's size by having a player stand on a chair during practice, Chaminade surprised and embarrassed the top-ranked Cavaliers 77-72 in one of the biggest upsets in college basketball history. The Houston Cougars, led by Fly Slammajama, were ranked number one in the nation on a 26-game winning streak and destined to be the next NCAA champs. That was until they ran into heavy underdogs North Carolina State. The Wolfpack kept the game close up to the dying seconds. With 44 ticks remaining and the score knotted at 52, the Wolfpack inbounded the ball and scrambled to set something up. Then in the dying seconds, they heaved a long-distance prayer toward the rim. That prayer was answered as North Carolina State's power forward caught the air ball and slammed it home at the buzzer to seal the victory 54-52. And who will ever forget North Carolina State's courageous coach's reaction? The date was April 1, 1985, when underdog Villanova met Georgetown. It was a game remembered by many as the most perfectly played NCAA championship game of all time. One of the largest national TV audiences ever, and a jam-packed Rupp Arena witnessed Villanova's stunning upset of the highly favored and richly talented Georgetown Hoyas to claim their first national title, 66-64. The Wildcats were on fire that night, going 22 for 28 from the field and ending up with a sizzling 78.6 field goal percentage. The 1987 championship game was the story of the hero and the goat. With only 25 seconds to go and the shot clock turned off, the Hoosiers' famous coach had no choice but to foul Q's freshman power forward. The freshman missed badly on the front end of a 1-on-1. Indiana grabbed the rebound, rushed down court, and the hero nailed a smart shot to clinch the championship 74-73. The 1989 championship game saw the Wolverines and Pirates both challenging for their school's first title. Michigan's coach, given the interim job one day before the tournament, inherited a team with four eventual first-round picks. But Seton Hall would not lay down. Trailing by 12 with 14:30 left in the second half, the Pirates battled the loaded Michigan team into overtime. It was in overtime that Michigan's big-scoring small forward and Mr. Clutch point guard led the team to a one-point victory, with Mr. Clutch hitting two free throws to seal the victory and the championship 80-79. The Rebels came into this game averaging 97.7 points per game, with an average margin of victory of 26 per game, and riding a 34-game winning streak. They also had the best starting lineup in all of college basketball, seeking a second straight NCAA championship. But that night, they ran into a Duke team that wouldn't be intimidated like they were in the 1990 NCAA championship. On March 28, 1992, number 32 from Duke had a perfect night. He shot 10 for 10 from the field and 10 for 10 from the free throw line. But no moment in the game was more perfect than the final shot. With 2.1 seconds left on the clock and down one in the first overtime, Duke was forced to launch a full-court inbound pass. The rest has become NCAA history. After winning 10 titles under their legendary coach, UCLA went through a 20-season drought. And if it weren't for the last-second heroics of the smallest player on the court, it could have been 21. The Bruins were laden with talented players, but found themselves down 1 point with 4.8 seconds left to the hard-working but largely unknown Missouri team. In the dying moments, with the Tigers faithful on the edge of their seats, tasting victory, UCLA inbounded the ball from their own baseline to their 5'9 floor general, who dashed the length of the court and hoisted an improbable shot which went off the backboard and in.